Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Creatnprocess. Today we're going to be creating this minimalist can design in Illustrator. We'll be using only 3 shades of color and try to get the maximum volume of our can design through the background color. So let's begin with designing process. Open a new Illustrator document. Pick up a red color using the color picker. Then using the rectangle tool, draw a rectangle same size of the artboard. And lock it using the keyboard shortcut Command or Control tool. Now we're going to be creating the can design. So select the rectangle tool and choose white color from the color swatches for a while. And then draw a rectangle of certain height. Reduce its width and switch it from fill color to stroke color. Then take a scissor tool and give one cut here and the other there. Now select the line with the selection tool and delete it. Now activate the ruler option using the shortcut Command or Control R and drag out 2 rulers that can be helpful while creating the shapes. Then lock it. Next, using the pen tool, add 2 anchor points at the intersection area. This point will help in maintaining the shapes. Now, using the direct selection tool, select the corner anchor points and drag it toward right side. Then click the circular icon and drag it to make the corner round. Here in the meanwhile, delete out the unwanted anchor points and edge the handles until you get a smooth curve. Now do the same for the upper corner and adjust only for this anchor point. Now select the stroke path and go to Effect 3D Revolve. Switch on the preview option, select right edge and edge the perspective angle, then click OK. After this, go to Object and click on Expand Appearance. Again go to Object and expand it one more time. This will convert the shape into fill object. Now select and ungroup it twice. This will separate out each pieces. Next, select the lower region except the top circle, then click on Unite option on the Pathfinder. This will give us a single shape for the body. Now arrange the top circular shape to front and place it in its original position. Next, we'll apply the stroke color. So select the stroke option and apply black color from the color panel. Now create a duplicate of this shape and place it on the top. Create one more duplicate of this shape and place it on the bottom. Then arrange it to back. Now select the bottom part and the body and using the shape builder tool, extract out the lower region. Then right click and ungroup it. Now select the background shape and delete it out. Now, by following the same process, extract out the top 2 shapes and ungroup it. Now select the extracted piece and remove the stroke color. Next, select the body shape and create a copy on top using the keyboard shortcut Command or Control C to copy and Command or Control F to paste in front. Then again make another copy and move it aside to give a little thickness. Now select the top 2 shapes and apply minus front option under Pathfinder. Fill it up with a color and extract out the required shapes using the Shape Builder tool and delete out the unwanted shapes. After these, select this particular vertices and drag it down to give a gap. Now here you can see that there are plenty of vertices. So in order to delete those, select the vertices using Direct Selection tool and go to Object, Path, Simplify. Keep the curve precision to 50% and click OK. Thus, we have removed the extra vertices. Now, using the pen tool, add few anchor points at the middle region and start adjusting the handles using the anchor point tool. Click and drag to modify the shape in order to give a rough feel. Next, we'll add the highlight. To create that, draw the curve using the pen tool. Draw out one more curve on top. Then, using the line segment tool, add few straight lines to get a rectangular shapes. Draw out one more curve's shape below and adjust the flow using the direct selection tool. In the next step, we'll extract out the shape. So before that, select our main shape and create a duplicate on top. Then selecting that, select all the curves and using the shape builder tool, extract out the shapes. Fill up the shapes with the color and arrange the back shape to the front. Now delete all the unwanted lines. In the next step, select the middle extracted part and apply fill color. Choose faded color. Next, change the stroke color and under stroke panel, change the profile to this. Then repeat the same process for the down part and the bottom circle part. After this, change the stroke size of bottom ellipse and the top ellipse. Now change the color of topmost ellipse. Next, match the middle body color with the background and also match those rectangular and the curved shapes color. Apply bright color. Now remove the black stroke color and delete out all these small pieces. In the next step, drag those small circles to get a slightly curved shape and do the same for all the corners. Then delete if there is any unwanted lines or path. Now just change the middle body color temporarily for the further steps which we are going to follow. So select the ellipse tool and create a small circle. Then extract half circle with a shape builder tool by selecting both circle and a middle body part. And now we can change the color of the middle part as well as the circle. Hence, take some copies of the circle and place them manually in order to show like water bubbles with different sizes. Now I'm changing the stroke size of the top middle extracted part. Next, go into the text part, press the shortcut T for the text tool and type out can. Here I have kept the suitable font style and change the color. Now increase the size and go to character palette for adjusting the size. Next, select the rectangular tool and create outer box under the text. Maintain the straight line matching the text. Now select free transform tool and adjust the shape by selecting both the text and the box. Then place it on the object by rotating it in 90 degree angle and increase the size to match the object. Next, go to object, envelope distort, make with mesh. Set the rows and columns, then click OK. Now pick the direct selection tool and select the anchor points to adjust the shape. Adjust it manually until you get the curved shape. Try to get a volume of the can by adjusting the handles. Just follow the shape of the can. In the next step, we'll create one ellipse at the bottom left side to create a shadow effect. Place it back in a correct shadow position, then change the fill color. Choose dark color for the shadow. Lastly, set the proper shadow size. Next, select the ellipse tool and create an ellipse on top of the object and fill it up with the color. Then take a copy of that ellipse and adjust the proportion with free transform tool. Now set the stroke size properly and adjust the exact proportion for both the circles. Next, we can also adjust the text part later on. You can do that by double clicking inside and replacing the text with a new text, for example cool. And finally, we have completed designing a minimalist can design inside Illustrator. The designing process was very simple. We have used a few new techniques and we have played with the negative space to create the volume of the design. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you want more updates on designing, don't forget to like, share and subscribe this channel. Thank you.